As a Hungarian living in the European Union, it's easy for me to stay in the UK, for instance. And even Brexit will not change that. Although everybody is unsure about what will happen, and I guess that's the idea. It's part of the negotiations, but that's not something I have to concern myself with. However, this sort of free movement was unheard of during the time my parents grew up. And if you studied a little bit of the history of the Eastern Bloc, you might just not be surprised when I say that travel was restricted. And then, of course, there's the logical direction of restriction to the West. Very few people got the actual passport issued by the state that allowed them to visit the USA or any other Western power country, I mean. However, it might not be a wide known fact that travel was restricted even within the Soviet countries. So Hungary was part of the Soviet Union, but kind of. There were a number of countries that were communist or socialist, because nobody achieved true communism. So Hungary was part of the Soviet bloc, but not officially part of Russia or the Soviet Union or whatever it's called. And the fun part is that if you wanted to travel to Moscow or wanted to travel to Czechoslovakia or Serbia or something, that just wasn't possible in an unlimited way. So the Soviet Union was nothing like the European Union. You had a passport in which, if I remember correctly, you had space for 4 stamps a year. So you were allowed to go to 4 other countries, or 4 times outside of your own country a year. And you'd have to get a special passport with the blessing of Moscow, or, well, technically the Hungarian government, but they were very strongly tied to Moscow, in order for you to be able to go abroad to the West. It's as if they were afraid that you might stay there. And nowadays, everybody is talking about how the United States is only a shadow of itself, and all the countries issued surveillance, and it's all 1984 and things like that. And I don't want to go in there. I don't want to go there. I'm just mentioning that there is plenty to complain about. But back then, the United States, England, France, and all these other countries were much better off than Hungary, for instance. So along with the travel restrictions, there was this theory of what Western countries looked like, because nobody really knew. Back then we didn't have Facebook, so we couldn't ask. And throughout my childhood, lots of things were connected the best, the idea of the best regarding the Western countries. So it's, even though I live somewhere else, I live west from Hungary, even though I experienced quite a lot of these other countries, including the US, the UK, Germany, and things like that, I still remember all these rumors going on regarding how amazing the United States is, and how it is the land of opportunities and the land of the free and the home of the brave, or whatever. But much like I discussed it before, when you live in a country and you grow up, you experience lots of negative things. So people in the US, even growing up in the 70s, 80s, would say that, no, that's not, it's a country. I mean, it's a good country, but I experienced plenty of bad things. And it's true for the UK, Germany, and Hungary as well. So it's very hard to compete. But the reason why a Hungarian would always win the complaint competition is because things were really, really bad back then. Like, really bad. So I wanted to talk about the travel stuff, but, well, that's fairly easy. But it's really connected with if you wanted to have quality stuff, you must have had some sort of way to import Western goods illegally. Because there were 2 major characteristics of the Soviet market. One, there wasn't enough stuff. Like, if you wanted to have a car, a new car, you had to wait 4 years. If you wanted to have, and because there were not enough cars. If you wanted to get a port, they might not have one. If you wanted to get something that is a little bit extra, like a little bit better clothes and a little bit better shoes that don't fall off or rot or whatever these clothing items do, in about half a year, then you would have had to get something like Adidas or whatever. Hence, Adidas and all these training things and brands, Western brands, are associated with class or better class, even in the Slavic part of the world. Because Adidas, back then, supplied average stuff by Western standards, but very quality clothing items compared to Hungarian standards or Russian standards or things like that. And that's quite interesting, and I'm not sure that if I was born in the US or the UK or some other country to the West, that I would truly understand what it is like to live in a country where these tiny things influence your perception of the world. So if you have any questions, then I will try my best to answer, especially regarding the travel stuff. I can always ask my dad. Well, he lived there. All right, thanks for watching, and goodbye.